Hi guys, I'm Kasturi Sarap and I welcome you all to this episode of Chitte Paise, in which we are going to discuss about the monetary policy which was announced on 7th of April 2021, that is today. What was so special about this monetary policy? First of all, this is the first bi-monthly policy in this financial year 2021. And secondly, coronavirus has hit India once again. This is the second wave of coronavirus that India is fighting. And so everybody's attention was to this monetary policy and everybody was keen to know what is RBI going to decide on the policy terms. So let us see how this monetary policy is going to benefit people like you and me. Let's get started. Let's see the five takeaways from today's RBI monetary policy. The first important announcement was repo rate remained unchanged at 4%. A lot of people were already expecting that RBI is not going to touch the repo rate this time and it will keep it unchanged at 4%. Now I'll tell you why a lower repo rate is beneficial for the economy. Whenever the repo rate is on the lower side, this is going to decrease the cost of borrowing for corporates, and corporates are going to borrow more and use that money in production activities. This will boost the economy by increasing the production. Now our economy is already on the recovery phase. Corona had hit us last year and economy had dampened. Lower repo rate is going to help economy recover faster. So this was a welcome move, and all the experts, stock market traders, everybody has celebrated this move of RBI to keep the repo rate unchanged at 4%. Second important announcement by the central bank was to have an accommodative policy. Corona has taken an ugly comeback in India, and still RBI is confident that the economic growth rate will continue at 10.5% for this fiscal year. Also, growth is of paramount importance to RBI, and hence the central bank has decided, keeping in mind the liquidity needs, to have an accommodative policy as long as it can, rather than a time-bound policy, in order to keep the inflation levels at the target level. The third important announcement, which is going to increase the reach of digital financial services, was to extend services like RTGS and NEFT to the non-banks. So all these services, NEFT and RTGS, were used only by banks till now. But RBI has decided to extend these services to non-banks like prepaid instrument issuers and white label ATMs. So this is going to improve the reach of digital financial services to people and also will reduce the settlement risk. The next and the fourth announcement is an extension of TLTRO, in which RBI is going to provide monetary support, liquidity support of 50,000 crore rupees to NABARD, NBH and SIDBI. So all these banks, they can use that money to issue fresh loans in this fiscal year. The fifth announcement is very important because this deals with liquidity and financial stability. RBI is going to infuse 1 lakh crore of amount in the first quarter of this financial year. So it has introduced a program called as GSAP, which is Government Security Acquisition Program, by which RBI is going to purchase the government securities from the market and is going to infuse liquidity in the market. So the first installment of purchase of government securities will be done on April 15th, and that will infuse a liquidity of 25,000 crores. By doing this, RBI is not only infusing liquidity in the system, but it is also giving financial stability by orderly evolution of the yield curve. So what do you guys feel about today's monetary policy? Post it in the comment sections.